Hello dear students, today we will start a new chapter, that is chapter number 14, factorization. Okay, so before starting this chapter, I will discuss some concepts. So here the first, that is factors. What is factor? So what is factor and how we can find the factor of any number? Or factor of algebraic expressions. Okay, in class 7 we have already studied about factors, and now here I am going to revise it. So simply, let's suppose 12 is the number, and what is the factor of 12? So what we can write 12 as a 12, we can write 1 into 12. Okay, so 1 into 12, that is 12. So 1 and 12 are the factors of 12, simply. Now second one, let's suppose we can also write 12 as a 2 into 6. Okay, so it will be 2 into 6 are 12. That means 2 and 6 are the factor of 12. Now we can also write 3 into 4, that is 12, so it will be also a factor of 12. Okay, so 3 into 4. Now how many factors are there? So the factor of 12 will be 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Now there are 6 factors of 12, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. Now this is the factor. Now how can you find the factor of algebraic expression? So let's suppose, here I am taking example, that is 5xy. Okay, so simply directly we can write the factors of 5xy will be 5 into x into y. So the factor will be 5x and y. Now let's suppose 15xy is given here. Okay, so 15 and xy. What is the factor of 15? Factor of 15 will be 3 into 5. This is the prime factor. Okay, 3 and 5 are the prime factor. So and x and y. So these are the factors of 15xy. That is 3, 5, x and y. Okay. So next example, 3x plus 2. Now let's suppose the expression is given here. We have to find the factors of that expression. So simply we can write 3 into x plus 2. Okay, x plus 2 are together. So it is multiplied into x and 3. 3 into x plus 2. X plus 2 is the whole expression. So now we can write 3 into x into, and this one is x plus 2. Okay, so these are the factors of 3x, x plus 2. Okay, so now the next topic, that is common factor. How can we find the common factor of any algebraic expression? Let's suppose the example will be 5xy plus 10x. Now this algebraic expression is given. We have to find the common factor of this algebraic expression. How can you factorize? By taking common factor. So simply, what is the factor of 5xy? We know that the 5 will be the factor, and x will be the factor, and y will be the factor. Y will be the factor, x will be the factor, and y will be the factor of 5xy. Now 10x, what is the factor of 10x? 2, 5 and x. 2 into 5 into x, that is 10x. 2, 5x is a factor of 10x. Now, how can we solve it? What is the common of 5xy and 2, 5x? 5 is the common and x is also the common. So, simply we can write 5 on x. Okay? Now, what is left here? Y is left here. 5x is common and y is left here. So, just write here. Y plus. And this will be 5x is common. So, 2 is left. So, y plus 2. Now, this is the process how to find the factorization by taking common factor. Okay? Now, the second one. That is regrouping terms. Okay? How can we factorize by the method regrouping terms? Okay? So the second one is the regrouping terms. When algebraic expressions are given and we have to factorize by the method of regrouping terms, how can we factorize by regrouping terms? So let's take, I'm taking the example, that is 4 terms are there. Okay, this is first term, this is second term, this is third term, this is fourth term. Okay, and here we have to factorize it. So simply just take common from both two terms. Okay, so 2xy and 2y. 2y will be common, so this will be 2y. Okay, and 2y is common, what is left here? X is left here. So this will be x plus, here 2y is common, what is left? 1 left. Okay, because we can write 2y into 1. So this is 1 left. Now plus 3x plus 3. What is common? 3 is the common. 3 are the term number which is in both terms. Okay, so just take 3 common here. So it will be x plus, and there will be 1. Okay. Now next step, this is first term and this is second term. There are two terms, this is first and this is second. Now x plus 1 and this is also x plus 1, and there are 3 and this is 2y. Simply what is common in both terms? X plus 1 is the common in both terms. So just take common x plus 1 in both terms. Here I am taking x plus 1 is the common. What is left in the first term? 2y left. Okay. So this is 2y plus. And here x plus 1 is common. 3 is left. So this will be the answer. And this is the method how to simplify by regrouping term. Okay. Now the next topic. How to factorize by using identities. So here some identities are given and we have to factorize the algebraic expression using these identities. So now first identity, that is a plus b whole square. So it will be a square plus b square plus 2ab. Now a minus b whole square, that is a square plus b square minus 2ab. Now these are two identities. Using these identities we can factorize the algebraic expression. Now just I'm taking example here, that is x square plus 8x plus 16. Okay, now this is the question and we have to factorize by using these identities. So simply the question is given here to convert in these form. Okay, a square plus b square plus 2ab. In these form we have to convert this question. So let's suppose it is given x square plus 16, we can write 16 as a square of 4. So it will be plus 4 square. Okay. So x is a and 4 is b. A plus b whole square. Okay. So a square plus b square plus 2a. That means a square, that is x square, and b square, that is 4 square, plus 2ab. So we have to convert 2ab. 8x is converted in the term 2ab. Okay. So 2 into a will be x and b will be 4. So this is x into 4. Now this is 2ab. We can multiply to for the 8x. Okay. This is 8x. Now this expression is in the form of a square plus b square plus 2ab. Now it is a plus b whole square. So directly we can write a plus b whole square, where a is x plus b is 4, and this will be whole square. Okay. Now again we can write x plus 4 whole square. So x plus 4 into x plus 4. Now this is the answer. And this is the method to factorize using identities. Now the next one, middle term splitting. This is the method to find, to factorize. This is the method that is middle term splitting. Okay. So let's suppose a question is given here, x square plus 5x plus 6. Okay. So this question we can factorize by using middle term splitting method. So how can we solve it? So simply we have to search two numbers. On multiplying of two numbers, 6 will become, and if we add or subtract, then it will be 5. Okay. So what we have to do? There are 6, so just find the factor of 6. Okay, so 2, 3, 6, 3, 1, 3. The factor of 6 will be 2 and 3. When we add these two numbers, that is 2 plus 3, that is 5, and 2 into 3, that means 6. So 2 and 3 are the numbers. On multiplying, we can get 6, and on addition, we can get 5. So directly we can write x square plus, at the place of 5, we can write 2 plus 3. So this is 2 plus 3, x plus, this will be 6. Now to simplify it, so it will be x square plus 2x plus 3x. Just take common from both two terms. Okay, x square and 2x. So x will be common here. So what is left? X plus, in this term, 2 is left. So this is 2. Now plus 3x plus 6. Just take common 3 here. So 3x plus 2. Okay, 3 plus 6. Now in both two terms, what is common? X plus 2 is common. So just take common x plus 2. That is, what is left in first term? X. Plus in second term, 3. And this is the answer. Okay? It's very simple. And this is the answer. This is the method. Middle term splitting. How to find, factorize this type of questions? So simply, the next question or next topic will be division of algebraic expressions. First of all, we will discuss monomial by monomial. Division of monomial by monomial. Let's suppose two monomials are given and we have to divide it. So, the question will be, x cube divided by 2x. So directly we can write 6x cube divided by 2x. So first of all, write the factors of 6x cube. So the factor of 6 will be 2 into 3. Now the factor of x cube will be 3 times x. Okay? 3 times x are there, so 2x, the factor of 2x will be 2 into x. Now 2 and 2 cancel out and x and x cancel out. What will be the answer? 3 into x, that is 3x square. This is the answer. Very simple. Now the next topic, that is polynomial by polynomial. Division of polynomial by polynomial. Is it clear to everyone? Okay. Let's suppose this question is given and these, there are two terms, first term and divided by second term. Both are polynomial. So directly, but how can we solve it? Directly we can write 24 x square y z plus x y square z. The first term is divided by second term, that is 8xyz. So it will be 8xyz. So 24 is written here and in bracket there are 6, there are 3 terms are written. This is first term, second term and third term. Okay, so what is the common from these 3 terms? That is x square yz, xy square z and xyz square. So x, y, z is the common in 3 terms because x, y and z, they are x, y, z, in all 3 terms x, y, z are the common. Okay, so just take common here. So 24 x, y, z. Okay, what is left in first term? X, y, z is common, so 1 x is left. Plus x, y square z. So here y is left and in this term z is left. Now directly we can divide it. So a 3 z 24 and x by z we can see out by x by z. Okay, what is left? 3 x plus y plus. Now this is the answer and this was the complete introduction of chapter number 14, that is factorization. In next video we will discuss exercise 14.1 from NCERT. Thank you so much, students.